Today, we're going to look at a polymerization technique called atom transfer radical polymerization, abbreviated ATRP. So, first of all, what is ATRP? ATRP is a controlled radical polymerization. This is a radical polymerization and it is controlled, so it's not a free radical polymerization. It is controlled by a process called a reversible deactivation step. You will see shortly what a reversible deactivation step is. ATRP was discovered in 1995 independently by two research groups, by the group of Mitsuo Sawamoto and by the two groups Jinshan Wang and Krzysztof Majewski. And as you can see, I have highlighted the name Krzysztof Majewski here because he is really the father of ATRP, and since 1995 he has really been the man developing ATRP further, and currently he's one of the 10 highest ranking chemists in the world and is very likely to receive a Nobel Prize within chemistry within his lifetime. So a very high prominent researcher we have here due to his contribution to this ATRP process. But now let's look at ATRP. What is ATRP? So let's look at the mechanism. This is the simplified mechanism of ATRP. Let's take each component separately. The first component to the left here, we have what's called the dormant species. We have some kind of reacting species here just called PN. This could be a small piece of polymer that is polymerizing, or it can even be a polymerization initiator. Then we have X here. X is a halogen atom. In the case here, it can either be chlorine, bromine, or iodide. So this is the dormant species, very important word, the dormant species. Secondly, we have the catalyst. It's a metal catalyst, or the catalyst is composed of a metal and a ligand. The most commonly used metal in ATP is copper, and so this would normally be copper in oxidation state 1 with a ligand associated to it. Then over here, on the right side, we have what is called the propagating radical. So to the left, the dormant species, to the right, the propagating radical. And the propagating radical is formed by the catalyst in oxidation state 1, abstracting a halogen atom in the so-called activation process, forming this radical, so-called propagating radical. And in that process, the catalyst goes into oxidation state 2, in this case for copper, where it has the halogen sitting on it now. The propagating radical is the reactive species of this reaction that can now react with monomer, as abbreviated here by M. And it can continuously add more and more monomers to it. And this is the desired reaction, what we want. But there's also undesired reactions in all kinds of polymerization. There's what's called termination reactions. This is just showing one type of termination reaction where two of these propagating radicals react with each other and terminate in this biradical reaction here. And this is very undesirable. Other termination reactions include reacting with water and impurities. But this is in general ATRP. So what you have you have a dormant species that is activated by a metal catalyst forming the propagating radical that can react with monomer. And then we have a deactivation by this copper 2 species over here to the right, which deactivate and reforms the dormant species, and it is this equilibrium between the activation and the deactivation that ensures we have a controlled radical polymerization and not just a free radical polymerization. This equilibrium, as illustrated, is always shifted very far to the left, so it's very deactivated. So only a very little amount of the time the propagating radical is present, and most of the time it's the dormant species present. If you look at this structure here is a generic structure of so-called polymerization initiator. Here the X, the halogen, is a bromide, and it's a very activated bromide. It's sitting on a tertiary carbon right next to a carbon group, so it's very activated, and this is a classic structure of an ATRP initiator. Here we have, as I said, the metal is often copper, it can also be iron. Then we have some ligands, normally nitrogen-containing ligands, for example, like this bipyridyl, this PMDTA ligand here, which coordinates into the metal that makes it like a catalyst. This here, just to show, we have abstracted the halogen atom and having the radical, the so-called propagating radical. And the monomers, this is just examples to left. We have an acrylate monomer, or more specifically, ethyl acrylate. In the middle, we have a metacrylate monomer, more specifically, methyl metacrylate. And to the right, we have styrene, which it makes polystyrene from. So this is the mechanism. But a very important thing, this is a controlled radical polymerization. All these types of reaction is very oxygen sensitive. And this is because the catalyst in oxidation state 1 is, if it sees oxygen, it dies and your reaction dies. But also the propagating radical would also very, very much like to react with oxygen in an oxygen termination event. So therefore, when you conduct your reaction, ATRP reactions in the lab, you need to have it very oxygen-free, so free from flow and so on. So this is very important and a limiting factor of ATRP. So exactly how does an ATRP go? We have some kind of initiator here. So you have an activation process by this normally cover one species. You form the propagating radical. A monomer comes in this case methane tetrachloride. You react with the methane tetrachloride. You add it to the structure and now have another radical, which you deactivate by the cover two species, again forming the dormant species. Then you can make a new activation, forming a propagating radical that again can react, in this case with a methane tetrachloride, just shown in red to show it's another monomer, a second monomer unit. And then you get this, and then you can simply repeat this activation, monomer deactivation, many, many times. And if you keep repeating this, you get a so-called polymer. So this is ATRP in the very, very simplest form, simply just to show you guys in a very easy setting what is it, so you just get the general understanding of an ATRP process, because ATRP is rather simple, actually. But I would really thank you for listening, and I really hope this video can help you understand the fabulous polymerization of ATRP. If you have any questions, please come with them in the comments, and I will be happy to answer your questions. Hope to see you another day. Chemistry Guy out.